Hey everybody, it's me, Steve Schnee, the CD Junkie. On this episode of CD Junkie, you know, we really need to talk about IAN McNABB. Now, I know that I've talked about IAN McNABB quite a bit on this channel. In fact, Ronnie, Barnett, and I even interviewed him for my Beach Blanket Fort bingo show. And he's a great guy, incredible musician. And he's got a new album coming out. But instead of just telling you he's got a new album coming out, I just want to quickly go through and show you just what an enormous catalog that this guy has. And none of these albums are stinkers. This guy is a top-notch singer-songwriter. He's a Liverpudlian. In fact, his original band, the Icicle Works, came from Liverpool. I mean, his musical DNA is the Beatles, Neil Young. You know, he's rock, he's folk, he's pop, he's alternative, he's indie rock, he's rock and roll, he's punk, he's everything and more. And he's an incredible singer-songwriter still, 40 years into his career, actually more than 40 years into his recording career. I mean, I think they did their first demo in, what, 82, 83, something like that. But he's incredible. He's an absolutely amazing artist. He has a song called I'm a Genius, and he's the only artist that gets a pass for doing that. Because what a lot of people don't realize is there's a very, very, very fine line between arrogance and confidence. And IAN McNABB is confidence, because the guy's really a humble guy when it really comes down to it. He's not arrogant. You know, I want to kind of tell you just real fast how I got into him. And that was because, you know, I used to work at Jack in the Box. I know. And one of my coworkers named John, he had driven by my house and he parked sort of across the street in the shade. And he just wanted to come over and chat. We were just having a chat. He was 3-4 feet in front of me. I'm sort of like leaning up against his car. And in between us is the driver's side car. And he's got the window rolled down. And, you know, we're on the outside of the car, but he's still got the radio on. And it was KROQ. And they started playing this song on the radio. And I started hearing it. And the more, you know, he was talking, he was probably telling me, yeah, you know, my dad said I couldn't do that. You know, he was probably telling me some kind of story. But I was zoning out, man, because I was listening to that song. And, you know, for the first 10, 15 seconds, I was thinking, well, I can't tell who this is. Could this be XTC? Because I was thinking maybe it kind of sounded like a Colin Moulding song from English Settlement that had come out about a year, a little more than that before. You know, because I'm like fly on the wall or something like that. And I'm thinking, no, that's not Colin Moulding. Who is this? And as he continued to talk, my mind is just going, shut up, John. I need to listen to this song. And as he kept talking, his voice started fading out, just like my voice is fading out now. And I started hearing the song. So I'm really listening to the song. And from that moment on, I've been a fan of IAN McNABB. Now, I didn't know IAN McNABB, who he was, until I went out and bought the album. 1984, debut album came out. Self-titled. The Icicle Works contains the song Whisper to a Scream, Birds Fly, which is actually called Birds Fly in the UK, but they figured that, you know, American audiences were whatever. But that song wasn't the big hit in the UK. That was the big hit in America. And that song is still, in fact, it appeared on Stranger Things. It's appeared on a lot of things over the years. And it's the song that sort of keeps on giving. But there is a CD version in the UK that's available, and it's this little box set here, and it has, gosh, I don't know, was it 3 CDs or something? It's filled with a bunch of unreleased stuff, which is absolutely fantastic. It's probably hard to get now, but this is the UK box set version of the Icicle Works album. And then in 1985, they put out Small Price of a Bicycle, and this is the 3 CD version on Cherry Red. And then they put out If You Want to Defeat the Enemy, Sing His Song in 1987. And that is also a 3 CD version on Cherry Red. And also Blind was their album from 1988. And this is also the 3 CD version on Cherry Red. Unfortunately, that version of the Icicle Works, the original trio, split up after the Blind album. Now, IAN McNABB did form a new version of Icicle Works for 1990's Permanent Damage. but it really didn't sound like the classic Icicle Works sound, but it still had a lot of great songs. It sounded more like an IAN McNABB solo album. But guess what happened 3 years later? That's right. IAN McNABB put out his first solo album called Truth and Beauty, and this is an expanded edition of that. 1994, he put out the album called Head Like a Rock. This was a Mercury Prize nominated album. This was probably his most commercially successful solo album. And on this album, he features members of Crazy Horse. So Crazy Horse is backing him. This album here is probably his most American sounding album, but it's still very, very IAN McNABB. He has a unique vocal style, a unique songwriting style. And when he's out there in front and his voice is bellowing out, it's pure, absolute magic. Now, the next release I have here is Mercy Beast, and this also features a couple tracks with Crazy Horse on it, and this is another great album. But the thing you have to know about IAN McNABB is he really doesn't make the same album twice. The next album is Party Political Broadcast on Behalf of the Emotional Party. It came out in 1998. One of my favorite IAN McNABB albums is just called IAN McNABB. This is probably his most popperific solo album up to this point. Just lots of great, powerful pop songs. Definitely worth checking out. And IAN McNABB's also a very prolific artist. So he put out a compilation of unreleased tracks, maybe demos, early versions, etc. And that's called Waifs and Strays. That came out in 2001. Then another great album comes out called The Gentleman Adventurer. And that came out in 2002. Then he put out a 2-CD set called Boots. And this was another collection of just non-album tracks, B-sides, alternate versions, working version, demos, etc. Incredible. This is such an amazing artist. And I can't understand why he isn't world-renowned. He should be. 2005, out comes the album Before All of This. And then there was a companion album that came out the same year, People Don't Stop Believing. And this contains, a couple alternate versions of songs off of that, songs that didn't make that album. And so much more there. Definitely worth tracking that down. And then to wrap up that part of his career, there was a compilation called Potency. And this is the 2-CD version. Great Things, which is a fantastic cover. This came out in 2009. And this it kind of features like do I want to call it drum and bass? More of sort of an electronic foundation, but still very, very IAN McNABB. He's just trying something new. And that's the thing that he does through every album. Little Episodes is another great album that came out in 2012. And this is just chock full of great songs, acoustic and rock and all this wonderful stuff. And then Eclectic Warrior came out in 2013. Another great collection of songs. In 2015, he put out the album Krugerrands. And what this is he's going through, some of the lesser known songs in his catalog and giving them sort of an overhaul. He's re-recording them. It's great to hear these new interpretations of songs because they're great songs. Then he put out an album called Respectfully Yours, and that came out in 2016. And this was cover versions of songs from other artists. So you're going to get a great collection of covers from IAN McNABB. And thank goodness he didn't record an American Songbook album. Good Lord, I think everybody has recorded an American Songbook album, except IAN McNABB. In 2017, he put out one of his best albums called Star Smile Strong. This is almost like he was rejuvenated. Everything here has been fantastic. He's one of this generation's greatest artists. Then, of course, Our Future in Space, another fantastic solo album. He's on a roll here, folks. This is an artist that is just as incredible as he was from day one. This is a guy who's still on top of his game. He's not putting out albums with crappy songs. He's putting out albums just filled with that secret sauce that so many other artists have lost along the way. Because after, the fame slides away, they maybe occasionally put out an album and then they put out their American Songbook albums, he keeps putting out new material. And he's always putting out new material. And it's really wonderful. Here's another fantastic album. It's called Utopian. That came out in 2021. I think this is the album that we did an interview with him for. And that was fantastic. And then he went back and he listened to like the original early Icicle Works demo tape or like a cassette that they had put out maybe before they got signed. And he thought, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to re-record these songs. So Ascending is him you know, using the same kind of electronics and stuff, and he's singing in the same key that he did 40 years ago. And that's another great release, and that came out in 2021. And in 2022, he put out yet another fantastic album called Nabby Road. But Ian McNabb has a brand new album coming called New Brighton Rock. And here it is, 2023, 40 years into his career, top of his game. He's never put out an album that was like, that's kind of okay. You never know what you're going to get. You know you're going to get a great Ian McNabb album. And I am here. Look, I'm telling you all this because I'm going to play you a little medley of songs from the new album called New Brighton Rock. It's not out yet. I haven't asked Ian if I could do this. More than likely, please watch this video before he asks me to take this down. Because I have heard the whole album, and I'm moved beyond words. So many great songs on this album. How does an artist 40-something years into his career still surprise the listener? I don't know. Whatever he's got something in him that keeps him creative, keeps him moving forward while never losing touch with why he's here, why he's making music. And it needs to be heard. He needs to be heard more. And right now, I'm going to play you a few tracks from his brand new album called New Brighton Rock. Definitely check this out. Sit back, relax, give this a listen, and I will see you on the other side. Don't shoot the wounded. Don't shoot.
Determined not to miss the bliss. Searching for the feeling that can't be obtained.
Anyway, that's it. I hope that you enjoyed that. I really want you to check out Ian McNabb. There's a couple links down below to things that I've done about his career in the past. There's also a link to the website where you can order his new album. It's probably going to be on CD and vinyl. CDs usually come first before the vinyl. But still, you really, really need to give this artist a listen because he's truly incredible. I say that a lot about Ian McNabb, and I mean that. You definitely need to check it out. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this video, and I really appreciate it if you comment, like, share, subscribe, ring that bell for future notifications. And until the next time, remember me. I'm Steve Schnee, the Ian McNabb Junkie.